Instruction 74, Janamejaya said, how did the sons of Dhritarashtra feel when they came to know that the Pandavas had, with Dhritarashtra's leave, left Hastinapura with all their wealth and jewels? Vaisampayana said, O king, learning that the Pandavas had been commanded by the wise Dhritarashtra to return to their capital, Dushasana went without loss of time on to his brother and hopeful of the Bharata race. Having arrived before Duryodhana with his counselors, the prince, afflicted with grief, began to say, "Hey, mighty warriors, that which we had won after so much trouble, the old man, our father, hath thrown away. Know, hey, that he hath made over the whole of that wealth to the foes." At these words, Duryodhana and Karna and Sakuni, the son of Suvala, all of whom were guided by vanity, united together and desirous of counteracting the sons of Pandu, approaching in haste, saw privately the wise king Dhritarashtra, the son of Vichitravirya, and spake unto him these pleasing and artful words. Duryodhana said, "Hast thou not heard, O king, what the learned Rihaspati, the preceptor of the celestials, said in course of counseling Sakra about mortals and politics? Even these, O slayer of foes, were the words of Rihaspati. Those enemies that always do wrong by stratagem or force should be slain by every means. If therefore, with the health of the Pandavas, we gratify the kings of the earth and then fight with the sons of Pandu, what reverses can overtake us? When one hath placed on the neck and back of venomous snakes, full of wrath for encompassing his destruction, is it possible for him to take them off, equipped with weapon and seated on their cars? The angry sons of Pandu, like wrathful and venomous snakes, will assuredly annihilate us. O father, even now Arjuna proceeds encased in mail and furnished with his couple of quivers, frequently taking up the Gandiva and breathing hard and casting angry glances around. It hath also been heard by us that Rikodara hastily ordering his car to be made ready and riding on it, is proceeding along, frequently whirling his heavy mace. Nakula also is going along with the sword in his grasp and the semicircular shield in his hand, and Sahadeva and the king Yudhishthira have made signs clearly testifying to their intentions. Having ascended their cars that are full of all kinds of arms, they are whipping their horses for going to Kandava soon and assembling their forces. Persecuted thus by us, they are incapable of forgiving us those injuries. Who is there among them that will forgive that insult to Draupadi? Blessed be thou. We will again gamble with the son of Pandu for sending them to exile. O bull among men, we are competent to bring them thus under our sway, dressed in skins. Either we or they, defeated at dice, shall repair to the woods for 12 years. The 13th year shall have to be spent in some inhabited country, unrecognized, and if recognized, an exile for another 12 years shall be the consequence. Either we or they shall live so. Let the play begin. Casting the dice, let the sons of Pandu once more play. O bull of the Bharata race, O king, even this is our highest duty. This Sakuni knoweth well the whole science of dice. Even if they succeed in observing this vow for 13 years, we shall be in the meantime firmly rooted in the kingdom and making alliances, assemble a vast invincible host and keep them content, so that we shall, O king, defeat the sons of Pandu if they reappear. Let this plan recommend itself to thee, O slayer of foes." Dhritarashtra said, "Bring back the Pandavas then. Indeed, even if they have gone a great way, let them come at once again to cast dice." Vaisampayana continued, "Then Drona, Somadatta and Valhika, Gautama, Vidura, the son of Drona and the mighty son of Dhritarashtra, by his Vaishya wife, Bhurishravas and Bhishma and that mighty warrior Vikarna all said, let not the play commence, let there be peace. But Dhritarashtra, partial to his sons, disregarding the counsels of all his wise friends and relatives, summoned the sons of Pandu. Thus ends the 74th section in the Anudyutha Parva of the Sabha Parva.